me now. So there you are, you know, you're a model, done lots of photo sessions, and you turn up to go in abroad sometimes, you know, so this is not out of the ordinary for you to do this.
Yeah, it was just normal.
It's just a normal work trip, thing.
Yeah.
When did you realise this was all going horribly wrong and something, because it must have been almost unbelievable.
Yeah, it was when I walked into the studio and it was a bit silent and I was trying to find the person. That's
right.
When I realised something wasn't quite right.
Okay, did you sort of think to yourself, I need to get out of here because this is weird?
Well, I just went round the corner and that's when it happened. So
right.
It was like no time to just think about getting
out or
anything.
Of course, yeah. Of course. Utterly bizarre, Chloe. An extraordinary thing to have happened. And this, you know, as we know, he's been jailed now. Why do you think so many people thought that this was false, or you were an attention seeker, or all of these accusations that have been hurled against you? Why do you think that is?
A major reason is because of how I act. I don't really show my emotion and I don't tear up or cry when I'm talking about it, but I've talked about it a lot of times. I had to say it to my lawyer, to the police, and a way of me coping is to kind of look at it from an outside point of view.
And then people think, well, that's a bit strange.
Yeah.
Because she's not crying or she's not getting
upset.
That's
my way of coping.
That's your way of coping with it.
Yeah.
Very, I mean, those 6 days you were with this person, very, very difficult to sort of somehow get yourself out of that situation, of course. Did you try and make him see you as a person rather than somebody he was going to sell off, presumably? Because, I mean, those were all the threats that were made to you, weren't they? They were going to sell you off in the sex trade or whatever.
Yeah.
All of this thing was going to happen. But how... So did you have to work quite hard to try and make him see you as you?
Yeah, well, he made it clear to me from the start that he was on my side trying to get me out, but he can't do that because of the organisation behind.
Right, OK.
So if I was to escape, not only would I die, but he would die also. So I knew he was on my side. So my sole focus when I was there was to just try and get him to like me more and more
right.
and more. And that's all I was focusing
it's
on.
It's almost like you getting him to fall in love with you. It's a little bit like that, isn't it?
Yeah.
I mean, do you think there was a big organisation behind this, or is he just a fantasist?
A fantasist.
Just totally.
Yeah, but obviously while I was there, I didn't,
well, you didn't
believe
know.
Anything else
no,
other
you,
than the fact
you
that it was a big organisation.
And now that he's been jailed, do you feel vindicated? Do you feel now you can say, look, this did happen to me. This
yeah,
was not
yeah.
something that we concocted in order for you to get some publicity. This actually happened.
Yeah, because whatever I would say about it, everyone just thought I was lying anyway, so there was no point in me even speaking, really.
That must be terrible, though, when something like that's happened to you and people aren't believing you.
I know, but then I knew this would be the result and the verdict would be guilty.
Right.
I just knew it. So all I had to do was wait for that, really.
But, Chloe, you know that there'll be people now watching and they'll be tweeting and they'll be going on social media and saying that they don't believe you.
I know,
do you feel as if what can you do?
No, because the people that do that, they're just ignorant. To believe like media headlines and stuff over a court, it's just that says more about the person than it does about me. So
you also said a lot of people judge you simply because of the way you look. I mean, you're a glamour model. You look glamorous.
It's
your job. You're a glamour model, and they kind of, it's almost like they don't give you as much sympathy as they might have someone else.
Yeah, and I think that's why people associate it with publicity as well, because how do you measure success as a glamour model? Publications and followers, things like that. But a different job would be measured differently, so they wouldn't associate that with publicity, and that's why I think it's become a big thing.
You've not changed yourself the way you look. You won't.
No.
And you won't change your job.
No.
But from this, I am sure, I mean, I'd be astounded if, you know, things like Celebrity Big Brother went knocking on your door and all of these kind of reality shows. Is that a way that you want to go down? You want to do that sort of thing?
No, not at the moment. That's not
you don't?
I'm looking,
you absolutely don't. So Love Island, that kind of malarkey?
That
wouldn't be your thing?
No.
Because I know you know Megan, who's in Love Island too, and she has had a lot of criticism as well.
Yeah.
And again, you've said it's kind of because of the way she looks.
Exactly. Like, she's one of the best-looking girls in there, and because of that, people are even trying to tear her down, like how much she spent on plastic surgery. Like, why does that matter? And it's just trying, it's just jealousy, really.
And do you have any thoughts on the man that did this to you? Do you have any thoughts about him at all? Or do you just try to kind of block it all out?
Kind of block it out, but then you can never understand someone like that.
Yeah.
Like, what his intentions were and why he did it, because he's just absolutely crazy.
I mean, you know, because there was a lot of effort went into that setup. You know, he would have got in touch with your agent.
I know, yeah,
he would have set up
Milan, it's the Paris as well.
Exactly.
And then failing to do that, then going to Milan.
I mean, a lot of thought has gone into that. So it's quite, I mean, do you feel more vulnerable? You seem a very strong girl, but that's obviously got to make you feel uncomfortable and vulnerable too, I would have thought.
It does, but then I trusted my agent that he would do the checks and he didn't.
Yeah, your agent, he's done a reply here because I know there's going to be an issue there. He says, the required information was given to me by the photographer, including a picture of the studio, Google Map location, details of surrounding streets, confirmation of a makeup artist and stylist. Chloe had also met the photographer before. What happened next, no one could have foreseen. and was completely out of mine and Chloe's control. Chloe was previously grateful for my support, and he said he's written a book about the kidnapping. It's one chapter about your kidnapping, but the book is about his career. Yeah, it's just, the whole thing just seems utterly, utterly so bizarre that I'm sure they're going to make a movie of it. Wouldn't you have thought?
Yeah.
Are people already thinking
so
about
many,
that?
So many aspects to it.
Yeah. I mean, I'd imagine a film, TV, documentary, because it is the most strangest part of your life.
To think that it went on for such a long time, like adding me 2 years before, then actually going through that. Like, say if I didn't model, how would he have got hold of me?
I know. It is actually very scary. It really is, you think about it. Have you had any help since this? You know, because you...
I haven't had counselling, no, because I thought when I was still believing that it was a big organisation, I thought talking to someone wouldn't help me.
Right.
Because in my mind, they're going to get me anyway. Mm. No one's going to reassure me of that. And then when I realised that it wasn't what I thought it was, then I just was so reassured and I was just focusing on trying to put it in the past as much as possible. So I just spent my time travelling and with friends.
Right, and you feel okay?
Yeah, I feel okay, yeah.
Don't rule it out, though, because you might need it in the future.
Yeah,
sometimes,
in the future,
you know,
yeah.
Sometimes things like that can just happen. You know, you might get flashbacks and things. It's always worth keeping an open mind, I think. I wish you all the best, Chloe, I really do. The book's out now. It's called The Untold Story of My Abduction, and it's in your words.
Yeah.
So it's from you, and it's called Kidnapped, and I wish you all the best.
Thank you.
What a terrible thing to have gone through. Absolutely awful. Thank you very much indeed.